Pakistan's support to terrorists was well exposed after the killing of Al-Qaeda chief Osama bin Laden in the town of Abbottabad in May 2011 by US Special Forces. Stunned by the incident, Pakistani authorities arrested Dr. Shakil Afridi, allegedly spying for CIA to trace Laden. On May 23, 2012, a court in the Khyber tribal region convicted Dr. Afridi and sentenced him to 33 years imprisonment, not for helping the CIA, but for supporting the Lashkar-e-Islam militant group. Afridi's lawyers said they would appeal against the judgment passed by Pakistan's archaic system of tribal justice.
बस खुद ही उन्होंने जो कुछ किया है तमाम कार्रवाई जो इंफॉर्मेशन हमें है उसके मुताबिक तमाम कार्रवाई एकतरफा हुई है तो यही वजह है कि हमने कमिश्नर साहब की अदालत में आज हम अपील जमा कर रहे हैं और यही तमाम नुकात हमने उठाए हैं
The doctor is not only in danger inside the prison but he faces threats from the Taliban and other terrorist organizations outside The Lashkar-e-Islam not only denied any links to Dr. Afridi, but said that they would kill him if given the chance. Shakil Afridi's brother said the decision was unjust and called upon Pakistan's Chief Justice to take sua moto notice of the case.
इस गलत फैसले के खिलाफ सुआ मोटो एक्शन लिया जाए, क्योंकि ये वन-साइडेड फैसला है, काले कानून का फैसला है, ट्राइबल एरिया का काला कानून है, उसके मुताबिक फैसला है। वाकई एबटाबाद में हुआ है। और फैसला एपीए खैबर सुना रहे हैं चंद जर्बे के लोगों के साथ मिलके तो ये कहां का इंसाफ है
Upset with the conviction of Dr. Afridi, US Senate plans to cut Pakistani aid by $33 million. US Secretary of State Hillary Clinton has said that Pakistan has no basis for holding Dr. Afridi. She called the move unjust and unwarranted.
As I've said before, the United States does not believe there is any basis for holding Dr. Afridi. We regret both the fact that he was convicted and the severity of his sentence. We are raising it, and we will continue to do so because we think that his treatment is unjust and unwarranted.
Pakistan remains a safe haven for a variety of terrorists. Their presence in the country is not only a regional security threat, but a cause of concern for the whole world.